So anyway, in this evening I'm discussing, well, I don't know what I'm finding in my papers here for my mother. My mother was a graduate student at La Universidad Benito Juarez de Durango in Mexico. So that was kind of cool. She did that in her life. Her studies were literature, Spanish literature. So she was quite affluent in her speaking. So yeah, I mean, all of her her writings and her books and her school studies. She was actually a teacher, a Spanish teacher. Eventually, so she did that a little bit when I was young, but then later on she became a real Spanish instructor. So it's very interesting, but no, I never really learned the language. But I'm head stuck at the moment. I'm head stuck at, like, I don't know. I got creepy past recollections or past people that I liaised with for a time, and I'm just like, can you just leave my brain? You know, I just hate it, and it's just like, you know, I just feel that aggression. You know, do you ever had that aggression? You know, this person is a continuance in thinking about you, even, or discussing you, or putting making phone calls here to this house about me. You know, absolutely unconscionable. You know, if I leave, you know, and I want to make ultimatums and statements, you know, to make this person back off. But then, in if I make these ultimatums and statements to make this person back off, it gives other people who are not needing these ultimatums, they're gonna back off. You know what I mean? So it's like this type of person that encroaches and encroaches and encroaches on you, you know, through their senility, and they won't back off. And so you make these demands, you make these ultimatum demands, and so it scares everybody else, because, well, she said it as an ultimatum demand, and so it applies, applicable to everyone. And so it's the type of person, that is a ruiner, a degradant ruiner, a continuant. And so I'm like, well, gosh dang it, you know, so what am I supposed to do, you know? When you're in a situation and you have no roof, you have no place to stay, women lie through their teeth. They just lie. They have to. They have to lie, or they may end up dead that night. So when you're put in a situation where you have to lie, and that person doesn't understand it, doesn't understand, you know, and no matter what I said, you know, just is making up fantasials about me, that I still exist in his life when I don't. And so I have this scary situation, and I'm just like, okay, do not call here any longer. And now I say that, I'm like, well, who am I saying it to, you know? And the announcement of the name, I can't even do that here online. I can't announce the name to the who. And so I'm sitting here like absolutely tortured, because this one human being is a pushy, is a goddamn pushy. I don't want anything to do with that goddamn human being. Do you understand? Nothing. Zero. Zilch. And I'm like, well, if I make the ultimatum and I say, if I called you back, maybe I was interested. You know? Usually in a male-female relationship, if there is any, there is communication. And that communication includes a telephone call, an email, something. Now, if there's none of that going on, that means zero. That means basta. It means go away. You know? And then I'm like, well, I don't know. So anyway, so meanwhile, I've been talking love sonnets and love wants into a cell phone that was thrown into an ocean somewhere, you know. I am just so angered that I was put in the situation. So angered that I had to be tainted. Do you understand? Tainted and filthed. I've been tainted and filthed by one visit, one flight to Dallas. I cannot believe it. I'm just, you know, and it's just like, wait, you know, what was I supposed to do? What was I supposed to do? Go sleep under a bush and risk my life. Was that it? Was that the deal? Go sleep under a bush and risk my life. Yeah, and so you can say words, and you can make them up. But these guys are senile. Dudes are senile over me sometimes, and I don't know what to do about it. If they become senile over me, or they were senile in the first place, which I believe so, some of them are just insane. And so how do you make the insanes just go away? How do you make them back off? You know, and they start up with their vendetta reason. You know, they have to get back into your life for some way, you know, even to hurt you, you know. They have to get back into your life. You know, somehow their penis has been damaged when it didn't even work in the first place. You know what I mean? And so this type of discussion has to end up on the internet, and it's gross, and it's filthy, and it's disgusting. And I'm really tired of really old men. What's the term? And I'll say really old men that have gross bodies. Let's say that. Really old men that have gross bodies. Because there are some really old men that have beautiful bodies. So, really old men. You have to like make everything so exact, don't you? Really old men that have bodies disgusting, preying upon younger women. Now, I don't know how to make a law against it, but there should be. There should just be a law. So anyhoot, I don't know. I'm just so disgusted. I'm just thinking about ballet. I just, you know, I'm even thinking about ballet, performing again and getting on stage and getting in a unitard and going on a starvation diet. It's that bad. It's that bad, you know, this jerk, this goddamn jerk. And I'm like, well, can I sue him? If he calls here, is there a possibility? Is there a way to sue the person if they call here? Because, you know, call my father. Is there a way I can sue them? You know, and in the mind set, you know, it's like, oh, it's obvious she's talking about me. It's obvious. No names were named. Well, anyway, yeah, so she was a graduate student. I hope she didn't have to. Hope she didn't have to get preyed upon by an old, ugly, nasty man with filthy, filthy, disgusting wants for a younger woman. I really hope so. I hope she wasn't preyed upon. But the chances are much higher, much higher. The older you get, and if you're alone, and if you have no money, the chances are much higher. So I really understand why women will kill themselves. They have every right to, because men are just disgusting human beings. More and more and more, they're just disgusting. Anyway, I just, like I said, I just want to talk about ballet. How do you block them from the audience? I don't even want them in the audience. They're just perverts. Just perverts. So that's the word I really want. Really, really want to say today is perverts. You know, and then it's the type of deal where it's like, okay, you have, like, not sex, but you have some kind of gross touchy with some old gross dude, and you're like, I have to replace it. I have to replace it immediately. And so I immediately do that. You know, you ever do that one? It's like, oh, that one was so awful, I just have to go out again. Hurry. And so then you have to go out again because that one was so awful. So you end up in this cycle of it and of chasing, running away from the last awful. And oh my God. And luckily, I found a reprieve. You know, it's not great, it's not marital, but it's at least a reprieve into celibacy. God, you guys are just disgusting. In general, yeah, in general. The majority of the male species is gross. What it wants to do to women, what it wants to put them through. Just gross. I perfectly understand why there are so many wanting lesbians out there. Absolutely understand it. I understand why there are so many for real lesbians. And it's like these guys, these types of guys, because they're allowed to do this, these types of guys are like, what's the deal? They even get more happy, you know, if they push a woman into lesbian. You know what I'm saying? They just get more happy. So they're just like devastants. They're devastants to what is good and normal and natural. So yeah, if you've ever had to sleep with senility, my gosh, we could have one of those meetup groups. We'll all get together. Had to sleep with senility. Oh my God. How disgusting. How absolutely disgusting. One, that the dance world didn't find me and say, hello, hello.